Attila, Total War, it's a game that we play. Attila, Total War, it's a game.
Alright, everybody, and we are back from a long hiatus of nonsense. This is Iron Hans with...
The Untrustworthy Beard.
And Gustafson.
Yeah.
Pretty much, those names are not going to be used for the rest of this video, but...
Except for Gustafson, probably.
Yeah, except for Gustafson. Gustafson will be consistent. But yeah. We are here with Total War Attila, the new Total War game. The last time a Total War game came out, it was handled so poorly that everyone hated it. So I want to see if they've improved upon their recipe for just being total shite in the very beginning of releasing a game. And they had an original idea for once and didn't just make a fucking sequel. Alright, here are the fucking bastards you can play as. The barbarians, the great migrators, I didn't read these beforehand, the nomadic tribes, the Roman Empire, the Eastern Empires. Why is the Roman Empire one word and then the Eastern Empires, which only have one faction, two? Whatever, fuck it. And the Norsemen. And then there's several different minor factions within these hierarchies. Alright, time for the discussion. Which should we do? I know it's Attila.
Well,
the Huns look like shit.
I like how the Great Migrator symbol looks like it's like a fawn riding a unicycle or something.
Or like you remember in the Pirates of the Caribbean when they're like riding the like watermill thing. Just imagine like Johnny Depp with antlers and the deer.
That's what he looks like. Of course, that guy's just turned to the side. I thought he had an eye patch. The Ostrogoth guy.
It's just a bunch of fucking gods.
Oh, fucking Alan.
Yeah.
How many of these motherfuckers have... Okay, none of the great migrators, surprise, surprise, have an actual settlement. The barbarians have settlements. The Huns, surprise, surprise, don't have settlements. The Roman Empire, kind of the biggest fucking nonsense in the world.
Yeah, that's what they do.
But, Jacob, check out the Sassanid Empires, dude.
Ooh, that...
Oh,
how do you even stack... That's not possible. Like,
check that shit out.
It's like Marge Simpson's brother.
Yeah, how does that
happen? That dude has a turban and a crown.
Oh, that guy's pretty good.
And a beard!
Yeah.
Good old Ctesiphon.
And a fucking goddamn scepter. He slapped bitches up and down the street.
They're Zoroastrian, so I say Sassanids.
Yeah, that does sound pretty good. This is pretty.
And then, this dude doesn't even give a fuck. The Danish do not give a fucking damn. And don't even start in Denmark. They don't care.
That's how I look when I'm at the urinal. I just have my arms folded, leaning back a little bit. Let everybody know I'm the boss.
Oh, dude, these guys are named the Geats. These people exist? Germanic paganism. What's the difference between Germanic paganism and... Are there any other kind of paganism?
Don't forget their faction leader, Dag.
Is Aryan Christian. You know, hashtag... You know.
We know.
Greek Christian and Latin Christian. What the fuck? Zoroastrianism. So, we have a vote for Zoroastrianism. And Jacob, what's your vote?
Yeah, I think I'll go with the Zoroastrianism guy as well, because he is closest to the areas of the map we're not familiar with. And
have I thought you were
going
to say because he's closest to the area of the map where the Seleucids were.
Yeah, that is also true.
All right, we're going to just go on normal for this one because
that is a good
idea. I'm going to check the campaign settings. Is there scary battles?
Spooky battles?
How many years does this last? Because, man, if we last like another 200 or 300 years, we're going to have a... Islam to deal with.
Ooh, that'll be a hell of a time.
We are Islam.
No, we're not.
We will be.
In like 300 years.
Yeah. This motherfucker is still gonna be alive. Alright, Zoroastrianism. YOLO.
I imagine like one of his like animations for like his health going down is like his somebody like shoots his hat off, like when the Pope would get a thing stuck in his head in medieval.
You mean the best part of the game?
Yeah. Those animations are great.
Yeah, they were.
Note to self, coffee while fucking having the flu is terrible. Awful.
I imagine that you get, like, the taste of the coffee, like, stuck in your mucus, and so you just, like, kind of taste it in your nose forever.
Oh, dude, I was eating, what was I eating? I was drinking, like, Gatorade, and it just tasted like, or no, I brushed my fucking teeth, and it tasted worse than anything I've ever tasted in my life.
Yeah, I brushed my teeth recently, and I switched over to a new tube of toothpaste that was actually an old tube of toothpaste, and like a Ooh. Bunch of like weird like nonsense came out, and it was like on the, it was like some weird like yellowish chemical, looked like urine, probably was. It like kind of like got some of it out, and I was like, it's probably fine, I can brush my teeth with that. I was late for class because I was retching. It was very, very powerful, whatever it was. And
so, today I learned Jacob brushes his teeth with piss.
Oh, damn. I feel like, we're not getting copyrighted.
What? Oh.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Your dominion over the
I hope
East
that's not
strong.
A thing that they do.
Dude, we got the fucking Emperor Palpatine as our advisor.
Now, you awesome. Must look to expand
it looks like he
the
has vampire fangs.
Rome is divided and surrounded by enemies.
Vampire
there may never
Palpatine.
Be a better time to reassert the natural order.
Yeah, I guess that was a long time ago, a galaxy far, far away. I mean,
so wait, do we have Constantinople? Oh, fuck, we gotta go get the Romans, damn it!
So a steady approach may
but we're away from the Huns! What if the Huns just get eliminated in the first, like, 5 seconds? Like, all of the games where the main faction just dies?
Thirsty for plunder and the blood of civilized men.
Wait, this guy's talking about blood of civilized men. He's totally a vampire.
Rule to the world. Does yeah. he shed the
They're
blood
appealing,
of the men?
Appealing to the teenage girl in me. That, will last until that person doesn't time. Exist. Alright. Make ready for war. Survive until the following date. That's not a good sign.
Spring of 400.
That's 4 years away.
Your objective
that is our goal.
Our objective not, is to survive 4 years. How long are turns? Are they like half a year or like...
I think they're
as the main administrative center
okay.
in the region, the settlement contains
what?
Both trade
okay,
and military
I'm just
buildings.
Looking at our country.
Settlements are the main consumer of food supplies
oh,
in a
fuck.
Province. So it is vitally
okay,
important
we
to
are
keep
alive.
Food production
okay,
buildings
let's, updated let's go into the tech.
To avoid
oh,
this
fuck.
Tab enables you to research the technology that will give you
shut up. That guy was pissing me off a lot.
Yeah.
He
was
he
cool
talked
first.
A whole lot.
Yeah, but
all right, so we got forced conscription. I almost said forced construction. Forced conscription enables,
build that shit!
Enables the building of levy center and infantry quarters, unlocks recruitment of Persian bowmen, which replaces Persian bows. So we actually put people behind them in Armenian
yeah, spears. Do we just have, like, floating bows?
I feel like that would
bows
be
on them.
More efficient.
That sounds better, yeah. You
there's
have
nothing
to, feed
to
the
shoot.
Bow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How do you kill
I
those?
Feel like we're going to go with... Forced conscription because you know, fuck bitches get money.
That's true. That was the
in order to
whatever our
proposal,
faction's name.
Double-click on a faction from the list.
Sassanid.
Then add diplomatic options by clicking on the
Empire.
Add offer or
oh.
demand buttons.
Can't say Sassanid without sass.
The proposed deal
Jacob?
Will take shape on the negotiation
That's a lot
table.
Of factions.
We are legit the Seleucid Empire where
a
everyone's a
when
puppet
ready,
state.
Click on the proposed
oh.
offer button.
Huh.
Cool.
Abershar puppet state. Area, Aria, Aria, no, it's Aria, I think. Puppet state, Armenia, puppet state, but they're pissed.
Yeah, that's what they're known for. And then they all died.
Wow.
That's true, right? That's what happened, right?
We have a non-aggression pact with the Romans.
Joke.
Non-aggression pact with the Romans, but they're pissed because, you know,
yeah.
MR, we're on good terms with a lot of the people that we've subjugated. I guess that's a good thing. We're gonna... Nah, these guys probably don't like us enough to give us trade. But we're gonna try anyway.
I greet you, as I guess we'll trade set up a little bit.
Non-aggression pact is an agreement between
two factions. Oh, God, shut the fuck up.
that's what I'm here for.
This option is used to broker...
Oh, no, he was talking about the advisor.
Sorry,
now you're talking about religion.
Trade route is open between your territory and
God,
your
this guy does not shut up. I regret 100% turning that shit on.
I'm glad we got to see him, though, you know?
Yeah, I mean... Okay, so I'm just wondering where our main enemies are. Who's the one that really doesn't like us? this person. Armenia.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, they're over there. All right, we'll go kill Armenia.
Wow.
Yeah.
Hashtag history. All right, so these are... These motherfuckers have pitchforks. The fuck is this?
Looks more like a rake from the thumbnail there. Abandon their settlements,
desolating the surrounding region as they go. I think we should raid. We should if the enemy is getting too close and it looks like you will
lose a region,
it is now possible to abandon its settlement in acting
as I can make camel heads to deny the invasion. Camel heads.
When you leave, a small amount will be added to your treasury. Any faction that resettles or
you know, I bet that they're our vampire advisor like camels because he like can ride on the back of them and then when he wants water, just sinks his fangs into the back.
It's like, look at that guy. That guy has fangs.
Yeah, he does. He's definitely a vampire.
Okay. We have cataphracts already? Swag! Why the fuck do we have cataphracts already?
A province consists of three regions, each one.
I regret giving you any form of power. Okay, so pretty much. Alright, wheat fields give us some food. It's like. God, there's so much bullshit on my screen compared to Rome 2. But it seems better laid out.
Oh! If you look at the top of the screen, I think it shows the seasons. So I think that each turn is a season. See that wheel up there? Yeah.
Yes. Yes, it is, Jacob.
Yeah.
Thank you for being not fucking useless.
Well, I mean, we were saying it was half a year before these guys.
Yo, should we get a horse breeder in Nisibis?
Yeah.
Nisibis is pissed.
Nisibis is more happy. Like it.
I mean, obviously, how do you make the people happy? Give them horse breeders.
That's a famous Roman saying.
By the ruin, the greater the squalor within
actually,
a settlement,
making a horse breeder
the more
make it worse.
It is that a disease epidemic.
We're gonna make an Oriental harbor because you know we gotta get China involved.
And lowers public order. And can
it's like I don't even realize that some of these places are like under my control because they're just like in the middle of the fucking desert. Sanitation
buildings. Welcome to Browntown.
I wish I could rename this settlement if I could. Dude,
try clicking on the name.
Fuck.
I don't think that's a thing you can do in Rome games because they're all like, or Total War games because they're like, history!
Spahan. Okay, literally we have like a legion of country. We have just a legion of half.
Troops
of goddamn,
can be stationed inside
holy
a
fuck,
settlement
we have so many more.
In the event. Farms, markets, and ports.
Yeah, this is
and settlements
a pretty
and
shitty country.
Them
it's just all desert.
Although food
yeah.
is automatically
yeah,
distributed across
yeah, I'm
the territory.
Impressed by how shitty it
if
is.
Total consumption
we're gonna
is
make a bazaar.
Production,
so Indiana can come.
Can occur. Which can lead to unrest
and shoot our
and
champion.
Rebellion.
These people have a catapult.
Make sure you keep food production.
Why do they have an
auger?
It's good for
siege.
It's good for crowd control, you know.
The Sassanid Empire. Sassanid Sultanate, mate. Wait, is that our?
It looks
our
like
king?
Him.
I think so.
Yep,
yeah,
that's
a
our king.
Master.
He's saying.
Oh yeah,
he's
and his name is Bahram. So,
yeah,
Bahram, you.
He's making a. He's going.
He's making a case for bringing back that fashion.
Oh. It's just weird because in Rome, like, all the stuff is in this bottom corner. So I'm, like, used to playing that because we played that to prepare for this. And now all of it's at the top of my screen.
This tab
oh, this guy looks
units
like a fucking asshole.
Available for recruitment in the selected province.
Oh. You mean
Yazdegerd?
Right-click
yes.
on the unit or ship card to see its
they
description.
Look like
left
oh,
click
Jotman.
On it to add it to the queue.
They just
and again to remove.
Just looks sick.
Recruitment cost is displayed underneath.
I think it has to do with the puke green background.
In the top left
yeah.
That's like baby vomit colored.
Yeah. We're gonna recruit this guy so he can become the new governor of this town. Oh, people are still mad here. I wonder why they're fucking mad.
In order to
wait,
move
was
the
there
entire force,
an army in there?
Make
wait,
sure
is the army with
a general is present.
I think the army left
select
with your king.
The settlement
yeah.
the general and right click on the point you wish to move to.
To be fair, they moved that army
really
quickly.
Cursor,
I'm impressed.
The army
yeah,
will
right.
walk to the chosen
I don't want
spot.
This. I don't want this army of trash. I'll keep the horses. What the fuck?
Eh?
I'll keep the onager too. Oh, fuck! Damn it! Fuck my ass!
Oh,
okay, I give up. That's coming with me. That entire army is just coming with me.
Yeah.
Alright. Is there anything else we can do?
That entire army hates you now.
Yeah.
Like, oh man, we just trekked across the desert. Guys, let's go back into the desert.
Nope.
Ah, fuck it. Let's turn around.
Just
camel,
like Moses.
You know, the camel herd, probably not the best option for this area, but I'm going to make it anyway.
That's the spirit. That's what you got to be all about.
Yeah. Yeah, YOLO it. Wait, can I actually already make an... How much... We're going to expand Meshin. Put a well? Nah, maintenance cost. Sacred site. We don't really need Zoroastrianism. Do we already have a levy camp in this area? Apparently not. I think we should put a levy camp so we can actually make units in this, like, province. Because this province is where our capital is and stuff like that. Where the fuck is our fucking faction leader? In
He's
the
right there.
Middle of the desert. But why does he start out there?
He didn't. He started out in Stacker.
Yeah, you moved
yeah,
him.
Yeah, exactly.
Then. Oh, oh, when he started in Stacker is the middle of the desert. I'll give you that one. Yeah.
Yeah.
Who the fuck wants their lesbian stronghold in the middle of fucking the desert? That doesn't look enjoyable.
I mean, if you're into that.
Crescent. What was it? The Fertile Crescent, my ass.
Yeah.
I mean, if you look at it compared to the rest of it, it's pretty fertile right there.
Yeah.
Yeah,
the
Stacker.
Euphrates right there.
Did you understand my reference with the Sassanid Sultanate, Jake?
Oh, yes, of course. It's good old, best game of all time on Blade Warband.
Following a new agreement, a trade route has been opened between you and your new
trading
partner.
What new trade route?
Guard it well, as your
lying
enemy.
Lying piece of shit. Stop trying to seduce me. All right.
Hey, baby, look at my teeth.
Yeah, right. We're going to give this guy some Persian levies because we make a fuck ton of money.
That's good.
Holy fuck, I can make a bunch of units in
Whoa,
one turn.
Yeah, look at that.
We'll give him one archer. And they're dirt cheap. Holy Jesus. Best game ever. Playing as shit.
We're playing as Browntown.
Oh my god, it was meant to be. Persia knew. They're like, you're gonna wanna play. What is this? Is that the. What the fuck is that?
That's a good question.
Looks like a temple.
Yeah. It's the... Yeah, no, that didn't help. Mousing over it didn't help.
Oof. We got a cavalry corral. We have the fucking... Kentucky Derby.
the Kentucky Derby with camels.
Are there any famous ruins in that area, Gustafson? Well, yes, obviously.
But. Yeah, ass loads of them.
Yeah, but what do you think that one might be there?
It could be Babylon.
Let's check out the mercenary list, because I don't usually use them, but let's check them out anyway before I just completely disregard it. Yeah. And the reason I don't use mercenaries is because they, in Rome 2, they cost, like, holy Jesus, they cost a fuck ton to maintain.
Yeah.
Like, say, 210 to maintain these mercenary desert spears, which just look like...
Those are dudes with spears. Yeah.
Yeah, they're just people who wrap something around their head and just put a spear in their hand.
Yeah.
There's Persian Brigade Desert Legionary Defectors.
Why would you want somebody called Defectors? That's not...
Desert Bowmen, Desert Hurlers, is everyone desert? Persian
yeah.
things, Persian Mounted, what? Hold on, there's so many mercenaries, I can't even... Mounted Warriors, Camel... Oh, Camel
oh,
Warriors.
Oh, dude, camels. Get them. Get them.
We're gonna... Roman Empire, you just wait. And there's also another onager that we could take, but we're not going to... I don't know how the onager is going to do. We're gonna
I like to imagine that the mercenary onager is just like one that you find in the middle of the desert.
Yeah, no, that's got to be a weird thing to try and sell, you know? Like,
Oh, they brought
the
back...
Summary tab gathers
they brought back the family tree.
Oh, good.
You to check the status of your
now I can know all about the ram.
And then his jealous brother, Yazdegrud, hashtag whatever his face is. What? Oh, God, I forgot what his name is, Jacob.
Yeah, you mean Bleda?
Yep, Bladder, there it is. Left click to assign your character to the
Sophist. Fucking Kusrau was actually an emperor.
How do you left click? What office does he need?
Like, I actually recognize that name.
I like how Yazdegred named his son after us.
Yeah. Oh, I can marry him. Put that motherfucker there. Oh.
Wait, we can? What?
Left click to assign your character an office. But there's no office.
The office is in that. Is
wait, no. Far left click on him and then look in the far right.
Oh, the governor's assigned.
Yeah, the Ars story. Ass story. Ass man, Os man, and Persian. And Spartan.
Spahan.
Yeah.
We're just going to go with the first one. Okay, thank you. I thought he wanted me to assign him to one of my daughters.
A Zoroastrian.
When unhappiness becomes
teaching
too
of Zoroaster,
the people will riot. Slaves will
corruption
revolt,
minus 5% religious
will occur.
Factors
that one's
which not may okay.
Cause this are food shortages, taxation,
Eastern Enlightenment.
The presence of rampaging
wait,
enemy
could that be
armies
the library?
And cultural unrest.
I don't think so. Doesn't look like much of a library, and if it is, shittiest library in A.
Well, I don't know about. There's a couple things wrong with that.
Would it be shittiest library ME?
Yeah.
Nah. Everywhere is NA.
We're all living in America.
America. I feel like I'm gonna go to war with the Eastern Roman Empire and just get absolutely railed, and then we'll be like, well, this is the end of the video.
Go conquer Armenia first.
Yeah.
Alright, some deep topics. What are we... Beginning of these games are always fucking boring as balls, because you're just like...
Watching the other turns go by? Yeah, look at that.
Yeah.
It's that guy had a scorpion symbol.
It's like the beginning of civilization.
Except minus the Baba Yetu.
Long-standing
wavering loyalty. See? Yes, the Earth is a bastard.
Reflected by increased income from trade routes over the life of the agreement.
Baba Yetu? It legitimately just won, like, Song of the Year. Just, like, total. It wasn't specified or anything. It was just, like, Grammy's just best Song
like,
of the Year.
The entire world agreed. They're like, yeah, this is Song of the Year.
Yeah.
How do I... Ooh, someone gained a trait, respectful. Ah. What a pal.
Let me just look this up for a second here. The Baba Yetu Awards. They actually changed the name of the Grammys and the Golden Globes to the Baba Yetu Awards.
Dude, please.
I don't know why Yazdegerd's such a cunt.
Fucking Baba Yetu Awards featuring your presenter for life, Kanye West.
Hashtag best show in the world. We're just gonna get the centralized authority. Dude, I don't know why Astagrid is such a goddamn bastard.
Okay, it was.
Dude, you would be pretty antsy too if you were named Astagrid.
This panel shows you the information.
Why did my brother get the cool name
your
of Bag?
Oh wait, you can give him
their abilities.
He dislikes war.
Along with details of household members or objects.
Wait, you can have illegitimate children? Oh. Game's the best.
I thought you were just talking about in general. You just discovered you could do that.
In real life, I was like, shit, I didn't even know. We are marching this motherfucker all the way across.
You know, if he's not trustworthy, you're in a particular part of the world where if you were to march him into the middle of nowhere, he would probably die.
It's true. We need to, like, make sure that suit... Wait, what? Why is this place pissed? Everywhere in the desert's getting mad. I wonder why.
Baba Yetu won Best Instrumental Arrangement Accompanying Vocalist category, making it the first video game theme nominated for a Grammy Award. And then it won the award, so it was also the first video game to win a Grammy Award. Also, it happened, like, in 2010, and it came out in, like, 2006. Just give it some time. That's like if we played, like... That's when we play a game and then sarcastically say Game of the Year, when it's, like, a game from a really long time ago.
Yeah.
Yeah,
and then
only they actually do that.
Yeah, that. I mean, Baba Yetu is pretty good.
Yeah, it is. It really psychs you up. You're
my
really cool.
Offer is changed.
Okay,
it's pretty great.
You want my daughter my words, like, for 300 gold? seems awesome.
Throw in a couple sheep and it's a deal.
Oh my god.
Ubar, King of Kings? They want Ubar, King of Kings? That's his title, King of Kings? Is this Ubar? Ooh. He is the King of Kings.
Ubar?
Yeah, I mean, marrying into the King of Kings is pretty good. Does this guy?
But he's unreliable.
That's. I guess. I mean, that is a pretty untrustworthy mustache. It looks kind of like he just kind of stuck it on.
He's very strong, apparently. Wait, I don't know what strength. I don't know if lower strength is better or higher strength.
I think it's overall. Like, you're the third strongest faction.
This guy reminds me of... he has a very untrustworthy beard.
Yeah. Doesn't even have a beard. Just a mustache.
Yeah, it's perfect.
Where's Parthia on our list of... What symbol do they have? This lion head thing? They're subjugated.
Yeah, if they're subjugated, then I mean, why bother having them marry your daughter?
Yeah, no. My daughter is for better people.
Yeah.
You opportunistic fuck.
I thought more of you people, but I guess I was wrong. Guess your daughter's too good for the King of Kings, huh?
King of Kings? You're the king of being subjugated, bruh?
We're just
putting. Oh God.
Many Armenian spears.
Yeah. We're gonna can be issued to any province where you have assigned a governor. I'm gonna disband them because they're ass. Lasting for the duration of his governorship, they have powerful effects. I'm just expecting them to be nothing but ass.
Or improve public order. Probably a good
bet. I'm just waiting. I'm also waiting for this province to like rebel hardcore.
Can you just put a bunch of soldiers in there and prevent them from doing that?
I could, but I'm waiting for my levy. My what the fuck am I even building? Levy center, so I can make Persian brigades and Persian hurlers.
Mm.
We're gonna hurl poo at our enemies.
That would make them at least uncomfortable.
Yeah, maybe.
Make them route. Like, oh god, make I just gotta route. Go. Gotta go clean up at home. Ow.
Ooh, we could put a courthouse here. Oh wait, hashtag poor.
Yeah, justice is pretty expensive.
Yeah. They could probably use justice in the fucking desert, I guess. Good.
When you selected a faction,
why
you also chose a family
such
or party
goddamn
to represent
cunt.
Within its
He has too many
system.
Children. Kill them all.
Your faction leader is
the last
the
time I played Rome 1, that's all I did.
The influence of each party member affects its
we
overall power.
We can't kill
power.
Everyone.
Winning battles
he's
as
a champion
general
rider.
And completing construction projects as a governor
he's a
may
handler.
Influence. Ugh. The popularity of your party is the sum total of its members' influence versus that of the opposing
What does this
party.
Ring mean? Oh, Yazdegerd is a fucking governor. Oh shit, I gave him too much power.
What's the worst that could happen?
Look what you did.
I honestly don't know, because this is a new game.
It just brings up a black screen with the white letters that says you lose.
We're gonna put Enlightenment in that province. Where's the other one? Dude, our bazaar is finished. Our bazaar is making us like an extra like 1,000 gold.
That's
swag.
Yeah, that's good. I will say that is good. If somebody told me you can be making 1,000 gold or not be making 1,000 gold, I'd say I'd take the 1,000 gold.
We're gonna do Pursuit of Truth. Zoroastrianism. I'm glad we constructed a bazaar. God, first 30 minutes of the game? Fucking nothing. Nothing but ass.
I bet the Huns are having a lot of fun right now, actually.
Yeah.
The Huns are just running around taking tons of settlements right now.
Oh my god, you know how scary it would be if the Huns just randomly, like, showed up?
Yeah.
That'd be great, I don't know.
They show up in a warship, like...
Illidan at their head. Yeah. You are not prepared! And then their units just died of desert fever.
Yeah. They they drop in like those in those weird Warhammer drop pods.
Who are the Sabirs? They're trying to fight the Sabirs, and I don't know where they are. Wait, your faction? Who is the? They're the aggressors. Oh, fuck you. Wait, I have to decline and break the alliance. Do I give a fuck? Ah, let's do it. Let's add some interest. The Sabir. Oh shit! And during, you know how it shows all the
Oh yeah, they're red.
Yeah. Natural causes. Who is this?
It's Ninsunu. I think he's running for like president in 2016 or something.
I can't click on anything.
Welcome to the end of the first episode of Attila the Total War. Thank you for watching. If you'd like to see more, click on this sweet thumbnail. It's a video about guys walking up a street and walking up a mountain and dying of natural causes.
It's back.
Never mind.
Yazdegerd, wavering loyalty.
He's so... I hate him. Why,
how
wait,
do you ensure that loyalty does not follow any further? Lockmeads? Where are the Lockmeads? That didn't help me at all. Fucking useless bastards. Why is this guy such a bastard?
Maybe he's supposed to be. You know, the legendary leader Yazdrigid? How he killed his brother?
He's a fucking legend, mate.
I think I misspelled that, but I'm Googling it. Ah, Yazdegerd the Third. He came into being, doing things around 200 years from now. So I doubt this is the like, same guy.
We have to like, as much as I really don't want to put infrastructure in. Shitty fucking. Oh wow, upgrading that to a city. That's expensive. We're gonna give it some water works. these people could use some water.
Yazdegerd the First, however, reigned from the year 399 to 420.
Wait, he reigned?
Yeah, he reigned, but I don't know if this is the same guy.
Wait, 399?
Oh, hey, how about that?
Plus 2% wealth. We don't really need wealth.
That does sound like the same guy, doesn't it?
Yazdegerd?
Yazdegerd the First, and he reigns from 399 to the year 420.
Huh.
At which point he blazed
no!
it.
Maybe that kind of explains our goal, then.
Yeah.
This kind of explains his wavering fucking loyalty.
Yeah.
Fucking bastard.
I mean, I did recognize one of the names on that family tree. It's like the son of the current king.
Yeah, and his predecessor is Bahram the Fourth, which is our current king.
Well then, so we're about to get backstabbed by our brother.
Let's see how he dies. Bahram is often regarded as a harsh man who neglected his duties. He has been portrayed as a weak king under whom his vassals regained influence, last under Shapur the Second. So it's really Shapur the Second's fault. It's like when the people blame Obama for Bush's stuff.
But how did he die? How did he die, Jacob?
Let me check here.
You fuck.
Doesn't seem to tell
if
me.
A faction's initial
he was apparently
or
so weak nobody cared what he
did. What you had in mind.
Death of the salesman,
use the
all right?
Yo, our wife, our daughter is becoming older and older, and the King of Kings still wants to wed her and bed her.
Oh god. In 399, Bahram's conduct, it is recorded, grew so unbearable that he was ultimately assassinated by his own troops, who surrounded him and shot him with arrows. He was succeeded by his brothers, Yazdegerd the First. That's bad.
So here's what we do. Take Yazdegerd, and we walk him into the middle of the Arabian Peninsula, and then we leave him there for a couple turns.
The Persian fucking brigade sucks so much.
Tell him the assignment is very, very important.
Dick, oh my god, they're so bad. Look at how bad that is. Poor armor piercing damage, poor armor, low health. He's the pagan. Akon.
What about Akon?
Akon. Akon's the army leader.
Oh.
Nice to meet you, sir.
We're gonna put a courthouse here because I was planning on doing that earlier, but I just was distracted by.
You put Akon in the middle of the desert. He's like, I'm so lonely.
You have selected a character belonging to another faction that you cannot control.
Who's a builder?
Please select one of your own.
What a builder.
Learn more about their abilities.
Fucking hashtag. We're gonna sit and wait to see what happens in 399. And if he revolts in 399 and our guy gets killed by his own troops, I'm gonna be pretty upset.
I mean, at least we'll be able to notice that we'll be able to kind of tell the future a little bit from using my smartphone, like some type of really lame episode of Quantum Leap.
Like a fucking shitty lexicon.
Yeah.
Actually, it's technically better than a lexicon because it's forever updated.
Yeah.
I do like the unit symbols, though. Like, instead of being flags, they're like circles with the laurels on the side, and depending on how filled up the laurels are is how big the army is.
Yeah, they do a lot of nice design stuff in this. I mean, it doesn't like remain persistent, which makes it a little bit harder to like get in immediately, but you know, it's like,
yeah,
whatever, don't make the same game over and over again.
Yastergird still pissed. I can upgrade wells. Ooh, public baths. Yeah, public baths. Wait, what? Oh, you need training grounds? Oh, fucking. I'm fucking feeling real salty right now.
What?
Are you afraid you're gonna die in the year 399?
I mean, probably.
It's coming up.
Yeah, it is.
You know that song, by the Gorillaz? Clint Eastwood? No, it's not Clint Eastwood. Fuck.
Windmills, swimming in the ocean, causing a commotion. That's them, right? Yeah.
Wait, he gained a rank? Oh, he has to grit so mad. He's gonna murder bitches.
I don't know if it's gonna be him, but
we're gonna move over here.
Probably for the best.
We're gonna move Baron over to where Yazdegrid is. Fair. Or the worst.
It's funny because, you know, usually when you, like, you're in history class and people are like, how do you know this weirdly bizarre specific history? And you're like, video games. Well, the opposite works, too, because if you had just known this off the top of your head, you'd be like, you're 399. Things are going to go poorly for me.
We're going to put him into... Oh, fuck, I can't. All right, we're going to put him into fortified stance after this. Bahram is going...
Being fortified doesn't help if your own soldiers are shooting you with arrows. Like, you have 240 guys that just have bows and arrows. Have you ever seen that movie Hero? It's going to be like that.
I actually have not.
No. It ends with a guy getting shot with a lot of arrows. It's an excessive amount.
Like in 300?
Yes. Except all used 300? On one guy.
The Western Roman Empire's turn is taking 300 years. I'm, like, trying to read some of the other factions.
Yeah, the Antlions and the Barbarians. And the Ruffians. And the Quadians.
Well, fucking Elijah! You're the reason that there's lag!
Talking about the biblical Elijah or the one we know in real life?
Is there a difference?
Because, I mean, honestly, I feel like we should be blaming more biblical figures. People are always blaming God for things. Why aren't we blaming Ezekiel? I mean, come on. Why aren't we blaming Jacob?
Got him, Jacob.
Right? Hate that guy. Yeah. What a piece of shit.
Every time a con man gets you, you're like, ah, well, I mean, it's not really his fault. Jacob was the first con man. Oh, there's this mod for Rome Total War that we might want to do a video on at some point. It's a religious Mormon mod, so it's about the Mormons, like, early history stuff.
Okay.
Yeah. Weird, right? Yeah.
I'm listening.
I don't know anything beyond that. I just thought that it was weird because, like...
I mean, you're not wrong.
Religion games are always interesting. Like Captain Bible and the Dome of Darkness, Gustafson. Get on those videos. Jeez.
I don't know how much food I'm about to run out. I actually need food. That's surprising that I need food. Which one gives me the most food? This one plus 70 food? Yeah, camels! Yeah! Yo, you run out of food quick.
That's what happens.
A character's household is the objects, assistants, and general hangers-on that he
or
she accumulates
whilst
carrying out their tasks, and which in turn affect their abilities.
I love getting minus money that I don't have to pay for units that I just have passively. Also, I'm sorry if you were looking for really good gameplay, but the beginning of this game, we're pretty much friends with everyone. We picked the worst fucking people.
Yeah, if we'd picked the Huns, we would have, like, five, like, 3D, like, battles going on by now, at least. We'd be straight
sorry,
murdering everyone.
But we chose the best faction.
Yeah.
Hashtag winning.
I'm gonna make a mod that's just another faction that's just Bleda. Just Bleda.
Alec Baldwin to the rescue.
Of course, the Empire of Bleda, he was succeeded by Alec Baldwin.
I will be honest. I seek coin as token of your good and continued friendship.
We don't want a non-aggression back with these people because we're going to go to war with Rome.
Can't say Sassanid without ass.
Ass.
Kanye would approve. Yazdegerd, pissed off, is all fucked. Oh, yep, knew that was coming. I'm trying to salvage the fucking shitty ass.
What was that bad omen thing that showed up?
Yeah, fucking everything.
There's something that you just went through really quickly that said bad omen. Whatever. This is a video, so I'm gonna go back and look at it at some point.
I'm running out of food. Put a sacred hill there. I want food.
We can ask the gods for food.
That's true.
Is that how that works?
That god, can you teach me how to turn grains of sand into rice?
Yeah, this is 100% out of my comfort zone. I use a lot of cavalry while I use a lot of infantry.
Can you imagine the ecological repercussions if you turn the entire Sahara Desert into rice?
Jeez, that'd be interesting.
The whole world
hashtag
would change. there wouldn't be much hunger in Africa anymore.
Thank you, Sherlock.
Yeah. Had that, turn that stuff, make it go south. And everybody has nothing but rice.
We'll put sheep here.
Are you saying you're putting sheep in Browntown?
Yeah, I guess so. They could get sheep. It's just like, I've overestimated the amount of, because we had like such a surplus of food, and I was like, oh, look at all this food.
In addition to skills gained through experience, characters develop traits that affect their abilities. Some traits are present from the beginning.
I'm like not even reading them, and I apologize. I'm just trying to get to a part where it's actually good. Oh, hey look! People who fucking hate us. Huzzah! Oh wait, no, that's the rebel army.
Well, they do hate us.
This is true.
Rebel scum. Does Nisibis even have a wall around it?
Nope.
Okay, well that would be interesting.
Nope. Not one bit.
I speak with a simple
tongue. Ooh, they're trying to give me bitches.
Accept or
minus
do not
two
accept,
and
but do so honestly.
This bitch.
They're just offering you free women?
Well, they're giving me money to take her. That's how bad she is.
Oh, that's pretty good.
Nah, she's a bitch.
Yeah, that's probably correct.
22. She can't get me bitches. You ever ask your bitch for other bitches?
Winning a battle isn't just about greater numbers.
Oh God.
The balance of units and the general's ability are important factors also.
Separatists. There we go.
Look at the strength ratio and any reinforcement information
before committing
yourself. I don't know how this is going
to go. Oh, they have an onager? How the fuck did that fucking...
It may not be possible to avoid
not that hard
combat.
To build. The buttons engineering on this panel departments make them all the time.
Battle options. Mouse over each one to see what it does.
Well, let's do this battle, and then that'll be the end of this episode. So, yeah.
Oh, this should be interesting.
Jacob?
Yes?
Could you explain to the good viewers what the Battle of Browntown is?
I don't know if that's relevant at this current conjecture.
No, it is. So why don't you explain to the good people?
There's a lot I need to explain about the Battle of Browntown.
Not at all. Just give a very simple definition of the Battle of Browntown.
There's so much context they don't understand that won't even make it funny. But either way, the Battle of Browntown is when you go to take a dump, and it's a very bloody one. And it is in reference to the very bloody battle in Browntown, Wisconsin, that happened during the Civil War. many
yeah.
men lost their lives.
Their battle in Wisconsin.
Yes, yes. The Confederates tried to go take a really long way around to flank.
Hashtag
Canada. And Jacob, how often would you say you experienced the Battle of Browntown?
I don't know why you're bringing this up like right now. We're like, I guess we're going into a battle, so I guess that doesn't happen for a while. Actually, I've had a few months clear of the red and the brown.
All right, let's see.
Why did you just know? I still don't understand to this day why you didn't go to the hospital as soon as you started shitting blood.
Because it happens, you know. You take hard enough dumps, you just have bloody poops. It's a thing.
No,
okay.
It is. Google it.
Viewers, do you ever take bloody shits? And if so, are you concerned or not?
Or not.
Oh, look, there's bridges that we have to get over.
Hey, guys, these are what our units look like. Color.
Tweet your responses at Noah Scanlon at Twitter.
Snapchat your penis to Jacob style.
Yeah, have you ever had bloody shits? If so, describe them and tweet them to at Noah Scanlon.
Yes.
That's it, at Noah Scanlon.
How big is this square? Not a square.
Square and its alternate?
Does
not
Harman
a fucking
Twitter?
Square. Does Harman have Twitter? I actually don't think so.
That's weird.
Yeah.
He has a Tinder.
Yeah, but that's all he needs.
Yeah. Once you got the pussy, that's all you really gotta.
Droge. So Harman Droge 4.
Well, he's the 7th. So I guess one of his older relatives is a time traveler.
Yeah, exactly.
And made a Twitter, but not him.
Melee cavalry ready.
Yeah, take advantage of those hills, man.
We're gonna put the barricade over here. This seems like such a bad idea.
Oh, you can put barricades in places.
Take time to explore the battle user interface. Press buttons and click on graphics for details of their function. Further information is available through tooltips when mousing over.
Are there civilians running around like getting murdered out there?
Oh my God!
Are they?
Yes.
I thought I saw some.
Oh yeah, they're hard.
Totally that's new. Is that none of the others?
They're all like old people though.
Oh dear. If I were younger, I'd be murdered.
Walking around like stupid.
Oh, they broke the wall.
Jesus Christ. That woman just hip checked the wall.
Yo, this game's
recruit,
pretty legit.
Dude, conscript her.
That's amazing. I legitimately like that a lot.
Conscript that woman.
That was a thing I always wondered about when you were assaulting like really tiny places. It was like, where are all the civilians? Are they just all soldiers?
I like these guys running with their shields up, like.
Yeah, like me when I play Dark Souls.
Jacob.
Yes.
How frequently do you think our soldiers experience the Battle of Browntown?
Like probably a tenth of them probably have it regularly. I mean, it really depends on the diet. So I don't really know enough about the diet of the people.
The early Sassanid diet.
Yeah, the early
Sassanid. This
Sassanid.
Is actually, this town, for being a shithole,
Fairly defensible.
Pretty fucking nice. Is there another bridge?
Kind of reminds me of those cities you make in Black and White that are just like haphazardly throw buildings everywhere because it's really hard to align them.
Yeah.
Haphazardly.
Speaking of which, Jacob, how often do you think Peter Molyneux experiences the Battle of Browntown?
You have a weird obsession. But I asked him, the answer is twice a day.
Okay.
He wants to have the best shits he can possibly have, so he tries really hard.
And then does he cry when you interview him?
That's really mean. That guy was really mean to him.
What are these guys getting shot from? Are these guys shooting arrows at them? Apparently they have bows. Gonna hardcore.
Oh, yeah.
That's
no good.
At the same time, I feel like he was kind of justified, though.
I mean, sure, that game wasn't good.
Especially when he's like, yeah, we're not gonna live, I know we didn't, like, fulfill a whole bunch of the backers' requests and stuff like that, but guess what, we're making a different game now. It's like, what?
Pretty much gotta hold this hill. Not gonna go well.
Viewers, if you backed Goddess and you ship blood, tweet at Noah Scanlon and tell him what you think about Goddess. I really hope Noah gets tweets.
I don't think that's gonna happen. But
I hope he does. Even if it's just me.
I don't think his name is at. I don't even.
No, it is. It actually is. It's at Noah's name.
No, it's at. It's but his tag is.
His name is like Noah. Yeah, his name is like Noah. But his tag is at Noah's name. Because he's a bitch. Noah, we love you. Noah, if you're mad at us, tweet at Noah Scanlon and tell us what you think.
I know. I 100% think I'm gonna lose.
Ooh. That guy. Ooh, that onager's doing work. And by doing work, I mean it like killed a couple people, and it would completely terrify me if I saw some guy in front of me just get liquefied by a giant rock.
Yeah.
Our general is being attacked. Keep him alive.
I surrender. Like I individually, as a person, surrender.
Get back in the fight, sir.
I don't know if our general will win this. Or nah. Actually, they're the same unit.
Is that our, it's not fucking your brother.
That would be nice, wouldn't it?
Yeah, it would be very convenient. Be like, we accidentally left the gates open.
I have an idea.
I hope it's a good idea.
It's not.
Dude, that would have been perfect. The treacherous center to the throne. Oh, okay. We accidentally left the gates open and forgot to put on his armor.
Jesus Christ, who the fuck is shooting me with arrows? They're like literally raining it down. Swag.
The blood of the sun.
Alright, this is what we're gonna do. Shoot them in the back. It's working.
Yeah, I'd be willing to totally sacrifice all the archers. Like, if that managed to pull the horsemen, they're like, we should go kill the archers because they'll be easy prey. That'd be great. Because then we just stab them in the back.
Where you can hit your archers.
Of course.
Yes. Yeah. Oh no.
The men have thrown down their weapons.
Yeah, they're
fleeing.
Fucking fleeing. They're getting fucking. We're trying. Wait, are these guys still alive? Go!
Most of them are still alive, actually.
Oh, Jesus. This game's battles are intense. You see, I didn't think that they were gonna...
I'm glad we didn't choose hard mode.
Well, no. I would be able to defend this with more than just... shitty...
You gave that woman at the beginning a spear.
I'd be afraid of her.
She could do that to a wall with her hip. Imagine what she could do to, like, an archer.
The men are wavering!
Beautiful.
Actually, these guys can just fucking kill these motherfuckers. Because they're fucking swordsmen. See? We got this, guys. 100%.
I mean,
if we win this, all me.
The odds are still better than I'd expect on the white line up at the top there.
Got him! Is dead.
Oh! That's good, I guess. Yeah. I mean,
I am the king of not losing.
These are only rebels, so I mean we can't.
Yeah, they're fucking very, very well. My scouts are being not useful. Let's just put the. Can I just put these guys in fucking melee? Oh, they actually
pressing
did it!
The melee button locks the really? Selected melee capable units
well
into melee mode.
Rebels. They have an honor
all attack orders will
yeah, they're out of honor gear ammo.
Hand attack until you click on it again.
They ran out of the means to keep turning your men into paste.
Tasty. Some good tomato paste. That's what it's made out of.
Are we actually not going to lose this?
Yeah, it looks a lot better now. You might do it. If people can't really break when you're defending as often. I mean, people
well, no,
already
they,
have.
They,
yeah. But defending home field advantage, man. We're the Seahawks. And
our men
they're
have given
the
up and are
New York
for their
Giants.
Lives.
What?
Did I accidentally say? Are those both football teams?
Yes.
Dang it. I meant to say Celtics. We're the Seahawks, they're the Celtics. There we go.
The Celtics?
Celtics. Whatever. So I just said the Red Sox. It's a safe one. That's my favorite basketball team.
Hashtag winning.
Yeah, it looks like it.
Not even like... The only problem is we're getting shot. These guys are getting shot. Brace.
It's acupuncture.
Go faster.
Their backs are gonna be so good after this.
Yeah, right.
Why can't you guys move? The fucking road.
I don't know, man. What if they put down landmines? Are they using mercenaries? I wonder.
This is our general. Who is this guy's name? Ardashir? He's a fucking god.
He's the master rider, isn't he?
And this is the Onager team, by the way.
Yeah. They're just rushing your archers.
This is like a fight of the inept. And then, we caught the archers.
Oh god, did you hear that horn? It was so half-assed. What?
Did we win?
Gustav said, did you not know you could have the sound on this entire time?
I know I could, I just needed it.
You can't hear yourself either. No, you can't. Oh, are you like recording with an integrated mic or something? Would be able to hear?
Well, I'm recording with it, that's it.
Oh, well, you should be fine. Whatever. Anyways, we won! Pyrrhic victory. Super good. Episode 1 completed.
Is that like a phallic victory? Doesn't it should.
For me, any type of phallic victory is Pyrrhic for me.